is so loud. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. First things first, I'm not wearing eyelashes today and it just feels weird, but I also kind of really like it. If you guys like lashless Jessica, let me know. I don't have any lashes because we're in quarantine right now and my lash hookup is like in the ghetto and I don't really have access to like going there right now. So yeah, we've been trying to rock the small lashes lately. And if you guys can't already tell by the title of this video, today we're gonna be talking about my tattoos. I'm really excited to be doing this today because I really feel like tattoos are just a different way to like express yourself. You can express yourself with like your hair and your makeup and your jewelry and all kinds of fun things, but tattoos are a permanent way of just kind of giving someone a glimpse into your life, and you can really spark up conversations with someone when you see a tattoo. So if you guys are not into tattoos, this video is not for you. I don't want any negative comments on that. Just go ahead and exit on out of here and let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so the very first tattoo that I got is this tattoo that I have on my wrist. And I can't remember how old I was when I got this tattoo. I want to say I was either 19 or 20. This was around the time where I was just about to get married, so maybe even 21. I'm not sure. I don't remember, to be honest with you, but it was close to the time where I was going to move in with Christian, which is my husband. And honestly, this was just like a random thing. So at the time, it was me, Christian, and my best friend at the time, and we all went out to go to the bar and like drink and have fun. We were just celebrating me like getting married and like being on my own and all that fun stuff. So it was just a spur of the moment kind of thing. We were on Elm Street, which is like a busier street in Dallas. It's like a party central kind of thing. So we went there and we decided that we were just gonna get tattoos that night. It's just, again, a spur of the moment kind of thing. And because it was just a spur of the moment, I didn't really have time to think about what I really wanted. I just knew that I always wanted a tattoo, and you know, again, I was starting to be out on my own and I'm like, this is what I'm gonna do because I've been wanting a tattoo for a while, even though I had no idea what I wanted to get. Well, I did have an idea of what I wanted to get. It's a bigger piece, but I was like, I'm just not gonna make it my first tattoo right now. We just didn't have the time. Hold on, let me tell Christian I'm filming. He's coming. Say hi, crazy hair. Sorry, not really sure where I left off. But again, this wasn't a planned tattoo. It was just, you know, we were there and we were gonna get something small. And my thing is, I've always loved the sun and the moon combination, and so I really knew that I wanted to get something with the sun and the moon. And at the time, I was very into a certain religion. If you guys, I'm not gonna go too into depth with that, but if you guys have seen my sexual abuse story, then you'll kind of know where I'm coming from. And if you haven't, if you were wanting to, you can go check out that video. It's very intense, so just a heads up on that. But again, I was very into Christianity at the time. So my husband kind of drew something up really quick. He was like, okay, we've got a cross, a sun, and a moon, bam. And I was like, super cute, fuck it, let's do it. So we decided to do it. And then my best friend at the time ended up getting a matching tattoo. So again, had no significance whatsoever. It was just something really cute that I wanted, and I wanted it on my wrist because that's normally the first place people get tattoos, is like on your wrist. I was like, oh, that's a thing, so I have to get it there. Now, with all that being said, I read a post on Facebook, I want to say, I don't even know, maybe like 4 years ago, and it's always stuck with me. And even though it stuck with me, I can't remember like the exact wording of it, but it was something along the lines of like, what if tattoos randomly appeared on your body throughout your life, and then you later on have to figure out what they mean. And I was like, huh, that's kind of cool. And I could never really resonate with that until recently. I want to say close to the time where I wanted to talk about my sexual abuse, that I found meaning for this tattoo. Now, this is in no way shaming a certain type of religion or anything like that. This is just my personal story, and it resonates with a lot of, you know, just my story in general, like my life in general. So don't be offended by it. This is just like, again, for me personally, this is what my tattoo means to me. So there's a lot of different ways that I look at it. For example, if we're gonna talk about religion, you've got the cross in the middle, and then you've got the sun and the moon here. When I kind of think of it, it's like religion, like I said, I've seen the great side of it, and then I've seen the not so great side of it. And it's kind of hard to talk about because it's like my whole life into like one tattoo. But with Christianity, you know, I had that traumatic experience happen to me. And then also like As another example, my mom ended up deciding to marry someone from the church, and my church group at the time was not okay with it. And I heard some really bad negative things about my mom that I was not okay with. A lot of people that were claiming to be Christians were bad mouthing my mother and bad mouthing me and my family, and I just was not about that. I was like, how can someone pretend to be so good and, you know, whatever, and then turn around and be such a bad person? So again, not bashing anyone, this is just my personal experience. When I look at this, it just reminds me to stay grounded and to stay humble and just to stick to me and not let anyone try to influence me to be a certain kind of way. You can see two sides to different things, and you just need to hold tight and true to what you believe in. And again, it just, I don't let anyone influence me on a certain kind of way. It just reminds me to stay me. I hope that makes sense. It's a lot of information, like I said. And this is probably the tattoo with the longest story behind it. But again, I resonate with that thing because there's no meaning behind it. But now every time I look at it, I can find all these different meanings towards it. And I really, really love and I really appreciate this tattoo. So the next tattoo that I got after this one is this one here. I didn't really think about how I was going to show you guys all my tattoos on my arms, but it's this one. It just says all is well. So I got this tattoo after this, and me personally, I have issues with anxiety every now and then, and this tattoo is just to remind me to slow it down and take things day by day. I have gone through so much in my life, and this just reminds me, you know, every day it's going to get a little better. You know, things will pass. I just need to take it one step at a time. I'm the type of person that will really look into my future, and I think about my future so much that it'll actually end up causing me a lot of issues later on because I'm so worried about the future and I'm not worried about the present, and or I'm not focusing on the present. So again, that's just my tattoo to just tell me to breathe. I know I'm talking kind of fast right now, but just tell me to breathe and calm down and just take it day by day. Okay, so the next tattoo we're gonna talk about is this one on my arm. So this tattoo kind of has a meaning, kind of doesn't have a meaning. When I got this one, it was on Mother's Day, and Christian asked me what I wanted for Mother's Day. I had no idea, so I was like, I just want another tattoo. You know, they say if you get one tattoo, it's really hard to stop. And I find that to be very true. I cannot stop. I like keep thinking of all these different tattoos that I want. And then I don't know if I said this, but I have 7 tattoos in total, and I just want way, way more. So this is a tattoo that I got for Mother's Day. I knew that I wanted floral on my body. I really want, it sounds kind of lame. I just want like tattoos, like a whole bunch of floral tattoos all over me. Like different kind of plants and flowers and that kind of deal. I feel like that really represents me. So yeah, this was my first start on that. And if you guys look at it, it's this really cute hand, and I like that it's very Victorian style, old school style with the flowers. And I think it's still kind of sassy because it's got these cute little nails here. So I really like it. The thing that makes this one have just a tiny bit of meaning behind it is, you know, it's got these flowers here, and then it's got these like daggers or arrows. This just reminds me to like be careful, like with who I trust with my heart and my soul and like my energy. So it just is like, is it a double-edged sword? I can't think right now. One of those, it's a saying, I don't know. You guys know what I'm talking about. Like someone pretends to be good, but they're not. They don't have your best interest in mind. So it just reminds me to be very careful. I feel like this video is gonna be kind of depressing because it's like, everyone's like fucked me over and that's all I want to talk about. But honestly, it's kind of the truth. I'm such a person that's like willing to give and give and give, and it's hard for me to sometimes just think about myself. So I like having these little reminders. So yeah, that's this tattoo. I really love it. I got it in Austin, and this was the first time that I met my favorite tattoo artist. Okay, the next tattoo that I have is behind my arm. It's this one. I'm trying to make sure my armpits look good for y'all. But it's this one here. Another sort of depressing tattoo. This is a tattoo to represent to make friends with your past or your demons, no matter how bad that is, just to go ahead and accept it and move forward. Plus, I always really wanted something skeletal. Like I either wanted a skull or like a little skeleton on me. I still feel like I want more skeletons, like a skeleton covered in flowers. Tattoo idea. But yeah, I really like, you know, anything with skeletons and all of that. I, even though I love being super flowery and naturey and hippie, I still have a little bit of like edginess to me, so I really wanted something to represent that. And of course I got it tattooed back here. Tattoo I also got off Elm Street, I believe. Or maybe it was Greenville. I don't know, it was either Greenville or Elm. One of those, but I got this tattoo. Okay, so now I've got the last tattoo on my arms, which is this one here. So if you guys don't know, I know it's hard to tell because she looks kind of edgy, but this is Frida Kahlo. I really love this tattoo, I do, but this is the only tattoo I'm not 100% in love with, and it just kind of sucks. So I'll tell you guys the story behind it really quick. The guy in Austin which did this tattoo, I absolutely fell in love with him because he was light-handed, he was quick, and I think the ink just looks great and the lines are really good. And I'm such a crybaby and I squirm for like everything, and the way he did this tattoo was super fast, no pain, and I was like, if I get a bigger piece, I'm going to him. So that's where we went. We went to Austin to get this tattoo. Because I am booked in advance, because I don't know why, I'm usually pretty good at planning, but I didn't. He didn't really know what I was looking for and what I wanted, and plus I couldn't figure out his name. It was so bad, it was just bad. But he kind of drew something up and I was like, I don't like that, let's do it this way. He kept doing something very traditional, and though I do like the traditional tattoos, I still wanted it to be modern and edgy, you know, something that really resonates with me. And so we were just going back and forth on all these ideas, and guys, we were at that tattoo shop for like 4 hours, still no design. And it was myself and Christian was just getting really irritated because we hadn't had breakfast, and he was just like feeling irritated, and I started feeling irritated, and I was like, you know what? He drew up this design and I was like, screw it, let's do it. Again, I do like it, but now that I look at it, I'm like, the cigarette was probably unnecessary because I don't condone smoking. Like, yeah, she was a smoker and everything, but I don't know, I feel like I should have just stuck it out and, you know, made it exactly how I wanted it. So one way that I'm thinking of fixing it is I really want to cover my arms in flowers around it, or like some kind of leaves or something. But yeah, that's the story behind the process of getting the tattoo. As far as the tattoo itself and why I decided to get it, I don't know how I feel about like the full reason of why I got this tattoo on here. I feel like that's a little personal, and like when I'm ready to talk about it, I will. But if you guys know anything about Frida, she was a huge feminist. She was an amazing painter. She's known for her paintings. And then not only that, but she was just a fucking badass. I respect the hell out of her. She was such a strong, independent ass bitch. Like, I fucking love her. Like, I just think, I don't know, I fucking love her. I love her. And when I was younger, my mom was really obsessed with Frida, and then my aunt was really obsessed with Frida. So I've seen Frida my entire life. Like, my mom would be buying anything Frida themed. And then my aunt was dating this guy at the time who was an artist, and he painted her this huge Frida collage, or not collage, but like portrait. It was ginormous, and I still remember it was like bright green. I'm pretty sure it's in my mom's house somewhere, but it was like bright green. And when I was like 7, y'all, I really thought I was a model, and I like posted up next to the photo like a mess, like straight up mess. I was like 7 years old posing and modeling next to this Frida photo, or this Frida painting. So yeah, I've always remembered that, because I don't know, my mom, like, I think she put lipstick on me, I don't know. So yeah, Frida's just always been a big part of my life, and it just reminds me of like my roots and my culture. And yeah, I think this is such a really cool tattoo. The last two tattoos are kind of combined, and they're on my feet, and I didn't think about how I was gonna show you guys my feet tattoos and how I can show you guys my feet without charging you. But I don't know if y'all can see this. That's one tattoo. And here's the other. So we've got more sun and the moon. I really love the sun and the moon here, but I really wanted a bigger sun and the moon. I didn't want like the cross in the middle of it, because you know, this is separate. So I really wanted those two factors. I just didn't know where I wanted it. I was thinking maybe I should get it on my arms, but all of my tattoos are on my arms, and I was like, Jess, like, spice it up, sis. So I was like, okay, I've been wanting tattoos on my feet, and I thought about covering my foot in a sun and a moon, but I'm also a baby, like I said, so I was like, you ain't gonna be able to handle that pain. So I decided to get it on the sides of my feet. These are tiny little tattoos, but I kind of feel like they're my favorite tattoos. They're just so cute, and I don't know, they're just so cute and I just like really love them. I like how they look on my feet. I just think it's adorable. So there's really not like a meaning behind the sun and the moon on my feet, and which is totally fine. You guys can definitely get tattoos with no meaning. You can get a tattoo just because you like the way the tattoo looks. I mean, hey, that's kind of what I've been doing. So yeah, I hope that you guys really enjoyed this video. Let me know which tattoo is your favorite on my body, and if you guys have any tattoos, I would love to know what you have, where you have it, and why you decided to get it. Like I said, I am not done getting tattoos. I really want a whole lot more. For example, there's one that I really want towards like the back of my neck and like back, I don't know, like back here, but I think I want to wait until I have my second baby, like once I'm clear to have another baby, because it's a breastfeeding tattoo and I really really want that to be like the main tattoo on my back. And then I kind of want my dog's face somewhere on me because I love him, and then maybe even my cat's face. I don't know. Your girl's got lists and lists of ideas on what I want to do. I hope you guys are staying safe in quarantine right now. I know it's really hard to be locked up, so I hope this video brings you joy, and maybe by the time this video goes out, we're not even in quarantine anymore. I love you guys so, 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 so much. If you guys haven't seen my last video, I did post a Life with Luca series, so that'll be posted here or down below if you guys want to go ahead and check that out. I love you guys so much, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.